Pour out a spirit of reverence and fortitude in your church, to make these your servants worthy ministers of your altar, and ardent and gentle heralds of your gospel. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
From the prophet Joel. Joel answered to Zophar, "But ask the animals, and they will teach you, the birds of the air, and they will tell you. Ask the plants of the earth, and they will teach you, and the fish of the sea will declare to you. Who among all these does not know that the hand of the Lord has done this? In his hand is the life of every living thing and the breath of every human being. Does not the ear test words as the palate tastes food? Is wisdom with the aged and understanding in length of days? With God are wisdom and strength. He has counsel and understanding. If he tears down, no one can rebuild. If he shuts someone in, no one can open up. If he withholds the waters, they dry up. If he sends them out, they overwhelm the land. With him are strength and wisdom. The deceived and the deceiver are his. He leads counselors away stripped and makes fools of judges." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lecture de la lettre de Saint Paul apôtre aux Philippiens. Philippiens 4, versets 4 à 9. Réjouissez-vous sans cesse dans le Seigneur. Je le dis encore, réjouissez-vous. Que votre modération soit connue de tous les hommes. Le Seigneur est proche. N'entretenez aucun souci, mais en tout besoin, recourez à l'oraison et à la prière, pénétrez d'actions de grâce. Alors, la paix de Dieu qui surpasse toute intelligence prendra sous sa garde vos cœurs et vos pensées dans le Christ Jésus. Enfin, frères, tout ce qu'il y a de vrai, de noble, de juste, de pur, d'aimable, d'honorable, tout ce qui peut y avoir de bon dans la vertu et la louange humaine, voilà ce que ce qui doit vous préoccuper. Ce que vous avez appris, reçu, entendu de moi et constaté en moi, voilà ce que vous devez pratiquer. Alors, le Dieu de la paix sera avec vous. Parole du Seigneur.
Six months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was a great deal of grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated, so also the fish, as much as they wanted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Those to be ordained, please come forward. Matthew Charlesworth.
Present.
Paul Robson.
Present.
Que ceux qui vont être ordonnés diacres s'avancent. Jean-Robert Déry.
Me voici.
Emmanuel Saint-Hilaire.
Me voici.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, for service as deacons.
You judge them to be worthy.
After inquiry among the people of Christ, and upon recommendation of those concerned with their training, I testify that they have been found worthy.
We rely on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ. We choose these men, our brothers, for the order of deacons.
À cette église, notre mère vous présente nos frères Jean-Robert, Emmanuel, et demande que vous les ordonniez pour la charge du diaconat.
Savez-vous ce sont les aptitudes requises?
Le peuple chrétien a été consulté, et ceux à qui il appartient d'en juger ont donné leur avis. Aussi, j'atteste qu'ils ont été jugés dignes d'être ordonnés.
Avec l'aide du Seigneur Jésus-Christ, notre Dieu et notre Sauveur, nous les choisissons pour l'ordre des diacres.
Let Gregory Kennedy, who is to be ordained priest, come forward.
Present.
He looks around at the people who had witnessed the soldier's disdain for him. Sad eyes look to him for comfort. After another brutal encounter with the military leader, he gathers up the host from the floor and leaves with the Blessed Sacrament. Again, he returns, vesting as he enters the church, and boldly prepares for a Mass and gives a powerful homily. The people of faith, the simple people, follow him. The military, vanquished for now, will ultimately murder Romero as he celebrates Mass on a later occasion. Romero noted in his diary, "I am a shepherd of my people. I have begun to learn." He grasped that God is close to the poor. Christ is one with them. The disrespect that the authorities had shown for the body of Christ, the reserved sacrament, was being meted out to the body of Christ, the people of God. Romero makes this link in his homily on that occasion. The role of the ordained, whether deacon, priest, or bishop, is to articulate the faith of the community. The shepherd's task is to be among them, ahead of them, and behind them. Our ordinands of today have been praying, studying, reflecting, and proposing the faith of the church for Christ's followers. Some months ago, Gregory Kennedy commented on the text that he had asked to be part of today's ordination ceremony, ones that are important to him in his spiritual development and growth. The passage from Job expresses Greg's sense of God at work in his beautiful creatures. The Spirit of God inhabits all of them. Today, on the vigil of Pentecost, we pray, "Lord, renew the Spirit that is in the world, in your creation." These are fitting texts, this one of Job, during the wait for the release of Pope Francis' encyclical on the environment. A sense of the sacredness of creation has long informed Greg's faith. He sees it as primal to his Jesuit vocation. Further, Greg hopes that throughout his priesthood he will be able to heed St. Paul's exhortation in the second reading to rejoice in the Lord. A theme that was also present in the beautiful song that we sang, "Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord." This wish always to preach the joy of the gospel, we know, is a leitmotif of the pontificate of Pope Francis. Greg also sees in John's telling of the multiplication of the loaves and fishes in John's gospel an expression of the startling dual aspect of Jesus Christ. He both miraculously feeds the hungry and cares enough for the material world to ensure that nothing is wasted. The Lord takes the little that we offer and multiplies it to feed the world. He yearns to give his body and blood to his disciples as food for our journey to the kingdom of the Father. The many times in coming years when Father Kennedy will celebrate Mass in his priesthood will tell of the Lord's wish that none be lost of all whom the Father has given to him. Since these, our brothers, are now to be advanced in the order of deacons and the order of priests, let us consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church to which they are about to be raised. They are to serve Christ, the great teacher, priest, and shepherd, by whose ministry his body, the church, is continually being built up here on earth into the people of God and the temple of the Holy Spirit. Priests and deacons, joined to the priestly office of bishops, will be consecrated for the preaching of the gospel, the sanctification and nourishment of God's people, and for divine worship, especially the Lord's sacrifice that we celebrate here. With the help of God, they should go about all these duties in such a way that you will recognize them as true disciples of him who came not to be served, but to serve. D'accord que c'est un, Emmanuel, Jean-Robert, Matthew, and Paul, et Paul, je vais vous imposer les mains. Vous allez être ordonné diacre. Le diaconat consiste le premier degré du sacrement de l'ordre qui marque pour toujours celui qui le reçoit. Ce n'est pas une institution. On ne fait pas de diacre. On est diacre. Le diacre est configuré au Christ serviteur. Il est la présence sacramentaire du Christ serviteur au milieu de nous. Pour comprendre le diaconat, il ne faut pas partir de ce que fait le diacre. Il peut faire des choses, très diverses selon les charismes personnels, les besoins de la mission, les étapes de la vie. Il faut partir de ce qu'il est, la présence sacramentaire du Christ serviteur. Autrement dit, ce n'est pas quelqu'un qui sera plus serviable que les autres, ou plus généreux, plus disponible. Quand on se situe uniquement dans le faire, on se place dans les questions d'organisation religieuse. L'Église n'est pas une organisation du système de religieux. Elle est mystère d'amour, voulu par Dieu pour le salut du monde. Sa raison d'être est de permettre à l'être humain de goûter l'amour de Dieu révélé dans le Christ. Et donc, quand vous serez diacre, c'est-à-dire serviteur de Jésus-Christ, qui s'est montré serviteur au milieu des disciples, accomplissez de tout cœur et dans charité la volonté de Dieu, servant avec joie en même temps le Seigneur et les personnes. Et puisque personne ne peut servir deux maîtres, considérez l'amour de l'argent et l'impureté comme l'asservissement aux idoles. Now, Emmanuel, Jean-Robert, Matthew and Paul, dear sons, who are to be raised in the order of deacons, the Lord has given you an example that what he has done, you should also do. Since by your own free choice you present yourself with the order of the diaconate, you should be men of good reputation, filled with wisdom and the Holy Spirit, as were those once chosen by the apostles for the ministry of charity. You will exercise your ministry committed to the celibate state. Know that celibacy is a sign of pastoral charity, an inspiration to it as well as the source of spiritual fruitfulness in the world. Compelled by the sincere love of Christ the Lord and living the state with total dedication, you will cling to Christ more easily with an undivided heart. You will free yourselves more completely from the service of God and man, and minister more effectively in the work of spiritual rebirth. Firmly rooted and grounded in faith, you are to show yourselves chaste and beyond reproach before God and man, as is proper for ministers of Christ and stewards of God's mysteries. Never allow yourselves to be turned away from the hope offered by the gospel. Now you are not only hearers of this gospel, but also its ministers. Hold to the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, expressed by your action and the word of God, which your lips proclaim, so that the Christian people brought to life by the Spirit may be a pure offering accepted by God. Then, on the last day, when you go out to meet the Lord, you'll be able to hear him say, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your Lord." Now, my dear son Gregory, you are to be raised to the order of priesthood. For your part, you will exercise the sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ the teacher. Impart to everyone the word of God, which you have received with joy. Meditating on the law of the Lord, see that you believe what you read, that you teach what you believe, that you practice what you teach. In this way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people of God. Let the holiness of your life be a delightful fragrance to Christ's faithful, so that by word and example you may build up the house, which is God's church. Likewise, you will exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying. For by your ministry, the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful will be made perfect, being united to the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered through your hands in an unbloody way on the altar, in union with the faithful, in celebration of sacraments. Understand, therefore, what you do, and imitate what you celebrate. As a celebrant of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, strive to put to death whatever in your members is sinful, and to walk in newness of life. Remember, when you gather others into the people of God through baptism, when you forgive sins in the name of Christ in the church and sacrament penance, when you comfort the sick with holy oil and celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer prayers and praise and thanks to God throughout the hours of the day, not only for the people of God, but for the whole world, remember then that you are taken from among men and appointed on their behalf for the things that pertain to God. Therefore, carry out the ministry of Christ with grace, with constant joy and genuine love, attending not to your own concerns, but to those of Jesus Christ. Honor your son, exercising for your part the office of Christ, the head and shepherd, while you united with the bishop and subject to him, strive to bring the faithful together in one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father, through Christ and the Holy Spirit. Keep always before your eyes the example of each other, imitated by us to the Lamb, who came not to be served but to serve, who came to seek God and to save all us all. Amen.
ordained deacons, you must declare before them, keep their attention, undertake this office. Are you willing to be ordained to the church's ministry by the laying on of hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit?
I am.
Are you resolved to discharge the office of deacon with humility and love in order to assist the bishop and the priest in the serve the people of Christ?
I am.
Are you resolved to hold the mystery of faith with a clear conscience as the apostle Richard, and to proclaim this faith in word and action as it is taught by the gospel and the church's tradition?
I am.
Are you resolved as a sign of your internal dedication to Christ to remain celibate for the sake of the kingdom and lifelong service to God and mankind?
I am.
Are you resolved to maintain and deepen a spirit of prayer appropriate to your way of life, and in keeping with what is required of you, celebrate faithfully the liturgy of the hours of the church and of the whole world?
I am.
Are you resolved to shape your way of life always according to the example of Christ, whose body and blood you will give to the people?
I am, with the help of God.
You promise respect and obedience to this diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God have begun the good work in you and bring it to the fulfillment. Promettez-vous de vivre en communion avec l'évêque de votre diocèse et votre supérieur légitime dans le respect et l'obéissance?
Oui, je le promets.
Que Dieu lui-même achève en tout ce qu'il a pu commencer. You promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop as your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God have begun a good work in you and bring it to fulfillment. Promettez-vous de vivre en communion avec l'évêque de votre diocèse et votre supérieur légitime dans le respect de l'obéissance?
Je le promets.
Que Dieu lui-même achève en vous ce qu'il a commencé.
Save your people.
May they remain strong and steadfast in Christ, giving to the world the witness of your conscience. May they in this life imitate your Son, who came not to be served, but to serve, and one day reign with him in heaven. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you.
Hear us, Lord our God, and pour out upon this servant of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the grace and power of the priesthood. In your sight, we offer this man for ordination, supported with your unfailing love. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Receives from you, Lord God, and be to others a model of right conduct.
May he be a faithful in working with the order of bishops so that the words of the gospel may reach the ends of the earth, and the family of nations made one in Christ may become God's one holy people. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you. accept from the holy people of God the gifts to be offered to him. Know what you are doing, and imitate the mystery and celebrate. Model your life in the mystery of the Lord's cross.
Thank you.
For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he sent the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Resurrection and ascension into heaven. As we look forward to his second coming, we offer you with thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with blessed Oscar Romero, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
Et maintenant, nous te supplions, Seigneur, par le sacrifice de nous réconcilier avec toi, étant au monde entier le salut et la paix. Affermis la foi et la charité de ton Église au long de son chemin sur la terre. Veille sur ton serviteur, le pape François, et notre évêque Thomas, et Terrence, l'ensemble des évêques, et Gregory, Emmanuel, Jean-Robert, et Matthew et Paul, qui viennent d'être ordonnés prêtres et diacres. Les autres prêtres, les autres diacres et tout le peuple d'Hergé. Écoute les prières de ta famille assemblée devant toi et ramène à toi très aimant tous tes enfants dispersés.
Pour nos frères et pour nos sœurs défunts, pour les personnes qui ont quitté ce monde et dont tu connais la droiture, nous te prions. Reçois-les dans ton royaume où nous espérons être comblés de ta gloire. Tous ensemble et pour l'éternité, par le Christ notre Seigneur, par qui tu donnes au monde toute grâce et tout bien.
Par lui, avec lui et en lui, à toi, Dieu le Père Tout-Puissant, la l'unité du Saint-Esprit, tout honneur et toute gloire pour les siècles des siècles.
every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Archbishop Terrence Prendergast. Thanks for him
and for his ongoing support for both Regis and the Regis Jesuit community. Your Grace, thank you very much. I'd also like to thank the MC, Monsignor Bernicquez, for coming from Ottawa as well to help us with the organizing the event here. I know parishes are 7-day week, 18-hour a day operations, and we have been burdening the Our Lady of Lourdes parish for the past 2 weeks on behalf of the community. I'd like to thank Father Sullivan and the parishioners here at Our Lady of Lourdes for accommodating us so graciously and freely. They never said no to anything. They're very kind, John. Thank you. To the choirs and to the dancers, thank you very much for your participation. And as well to David Ely and Kevin and Carlos from Cardinal House, thank you as well. And the longer thank you very much to Regis College and the faculty and staff and fellow students of our men who've kind of helped to form them, as well as obviously to the families who have brought these men to us. On behalf of the Society of Jesus of our provinces, and I maybe presumptuous to say on behalf of the church, thank you very much. You have given us men who are generous and people of faith and service, reflective people who are people of the gospel and know something about it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to you as parents and brothers and sisters and friends. Thank you. Three small but important things. After this celebration, there will be a reception prepared by Mary Moore very expertly and very kindly. If you just basically want to go out this door here across the parking lot, there will be food and refreshment and opportunity for conversation. The ritual celebrants and the altar party will be leaving.
Let's pray for God's blessing, especially on our ordinance, but also on all of us gathered here.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
Dieu le Père et le Pasteur de son Église, qui vous soutient toujours de sa grâce pour que vous accomplissiez fidèlement notre charge de prêtre ou de diacre.
Amen.
May he who has entrusted deacons with preaching the gospel and serving both altar and people make you fervent witnesses to the gospel, ministers of charity in the world.
Amen.
And he may you who are priests through shepherds to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in unity of the body of Christ.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your lives.
Amen.